Hello, this is Vincent. I haven't seen you since, I unwillingly retired from my former post as head of security over at the Diamond Casino. I'd like to offer you a lucrative, albeit unorthodox, opportunity to make some money and sabotage one of your long-standing adversaries. If you're interested, meet me at the Vespucci police station.
Yeah, what's up? Well, I didn't take it.
Advise going inside. Not with your reputation for depravity and general aversion to the law, in all seriousness. Your countenance is quite discernible, and there are certain of my consociates who would take it upon themselves to exercise their right to lethal force were they to encounter you in person. But it's good to cross paths with you again, my friend. After head of security at the Diamond, this isn't exactly what I had in mind, but it's still a long way from a mall cop, right? Let's take a walk. Relax. I'm a cop, but I'm not a cop. This is just where the universe put me right now. I mean, I have my path and you have yours. And quite frankly, I don't give a damn about your antics out there. In fact, we may be able to assist each other. I mean, check this out. You see that misguided individual? How do you think he's gotten away with selling drugs in front of that burger shop very conspicuously for 10 years now? In front of the largest department in the city. He cuts them in.
Effenberger, you copy? Yo, Effenberger.
I copy.
Worst last name ever, dude. I mean, effing what? Anyway, when you got five, we all need some effing coffee down here on Dick's. And don't forget the effing cream and sugar.
Copy that. Oh, these motherfuckers. I'm out here getting coffee for cops on the take. And that guy over there is only a modicum of the issue. There's a new cartel running a large-scale cocaine operation out of the Cluckin Bell factory in Palito Bay. And be in no doubt, the cops, they're not only turning a blind eye, they're actively facilitating. If you ask me, the cartel and the cops can both go to hell, preferably on the back of the same bullet. I'm talking about a surgical strike, man. Taking out the whole operation. That's why I came to you. Let's go somewhere a bit more unfrequented. I understand your motivation in these matters. If you raid that factory, anything you find is yours to keep. But this isn't about the drugs for me. This is about these assholes running the biggest protection racket in the state. That's the kind of status quo I cannot abide. As far as my part, I can provide all the intel you need. Records, names, locations. We will need to educate ourselves on the factory, though. Gather materials so you can attack it with style and aptitude.
Ding fucking dong, Officer Effenberger. We're effing falling asleep over here. Get us some effing coffee.
Copy that. I'm on my way. Think about it. If anybody deserves to be fucked with, it's these guys. Can I count you in? Excellent. Now on to the first order of business. Acquire some funds. And fortuitously, we have files on some money laundering operations not far from here. The department allows them to operate for a share of the profits. I suggest we take a more proactive stance. Time to do what you do. I'll call you. Let me take these fucking assholes their coffee.
Thank you.
isn't in circulation. While you're hard at work, allow me to explain some of the background to our endeavor. A few months ago, a new cartel arrived in San Andreas. They came up with a pretty smart plan to get their operation up and running. Pay key employees at Cluckin Bell to look the other way while they use their distribution network to move large amounts of cocaine. The factory up in Palito Bay is pretty much a giant processing facility for the cartel. Every other Cluckin Bell van you see in town has a brick of coke under the mega mills. And of course, corrupt elements of the LSPD were only too eager to get cut in. Ingenious, right? But they think they got this whole thing sewn up, and that's where we come in.
What's up?
Sometimes I just want to dance.
Why did I take it?
Fucking hell.
I haven't been over in weeks.
Hey, man!
I don't give up.
Solid fund to use on the rest of our planning efforts, the first leg of which I'll get to work on right now. I'll be in touch. All right, let's discuss a potential way into this place. The cartel are paying off employees of Cluckin Bell to use their factory as a cover. There are a couple things we'll need in order to solidify my current infiltration plan. Let's move. Coordinates coming your way. I have a checklist for today's operation. Number one, allow laptop from a Cluckin Bell employee on the cartel's payroll. It's got critical intel for our operation. Number two, a hacking device which is going to help us pilot a train. And that brings me to number three. We need a train. That's how we're getting into the factory. By the way, don't worry. We may share a goal, but I'm fully aware we do not share a motivation. I've made sure sufficient funds are allocated to recompense you for your efforts today. Cocaine, this laptop's gonna give us a window into their schedules. I just sent you a CCTV image of the guy. You got a choice. Steal the laptop behind his back or incapacitate him first. I'll leave it to you. This guy's been living out here on the DL. Not easy in a truck stacked with so much tech, it has its own gravitational pull. Gotta be in someone's pocket.
changing mag.
Get down!
Carlos got hit.
Okay, progress update. The train you acquired has been discreetly relocated into storage, where it will remain until the day of the raid. Things are coming together. Next on the to-do list, acquiring weapons and gear, or the getaway vehicle. Your choice.
What about having an open marriage?
So, we have some important yet enjoyable decisions to make. On the one hand, you need to acquire your preferred weapons and gear. On the other, you need to acquire your getaway vehicle. We'll need to steal both. These can't be traced back to us. Where would you like to start? Rockets should have an ample supply of weapons and gear. Kit secure. Bring it all back to the lockup.
Drop that weapon!
If you're feeling voracious, you can hit more than one gang and seize any extra equipment. Whatever you get, we'll make sure it's available to you when we hit the factory. Trifled with will have reinforcements waiting if you ever return. For example, to steal one of their cars.
Pull back!
Suffice for our purposes. If you want more options, be my guest. When you're ready, just send me a message confirming the equipment you want to use.
Job. Now that you've secured all the weapons and gear necessary to take on a Cluckin Bell factory overrun by the cartel, we should discuss your means of escape.
Oh, please.
Next up, acquiring a getaway vehicle. We need to take the same precautions we did for the weapons. We steal it from a gang, so the trail leads to them instead of us.
People are obsessed with health, but then they rave about this place called Up and Adam Burger. Yeah, they say we live in flyover country, but at least you can...
Thank you.
Okay. Possible getaway vehicles at these three locations. I'm sending surveillance images to you. These are our potential targets. I'm sure you have plenty of vehicles capable of getting you out of Cluckin Bell with all your extremities intact, but we need something that can't be traced to us. I've acquired three suitable options for a getaway car. All of them are sourced from local gangs bribing the LSPD to turn a blind eye to their activities. If the car ends up getting traced, the trail leads back to them, not us. We'll only need to use one of them for the raid. The choice, as always, is yours. Won't be messing around. The vehicle will be in a secured area. Locate it and get it out of there using whatever means necessary. Back to our old friends, I see. They must love you by now.
Motherfucker! He's unhit!
garage close to the factory where the car will be safe. Excellent choice. We're not in any rush out there, so feel free to pay the other gangs a visit.
What miracle did you want me to perform?
Choice of vehicle. Send me a message. Getaway car secured. Well done. Keep your head down on your way out. I'll give you a call soon. Excellent. I've been investigating where the factory workers park, and fortunately for us, the garage seems to get completely ignored. Your getaway car will remain undisturbed until it's time for the raid. Hey, so I understand that your MO is up to you, but there are steps you can take to ensure the element of surprise is on your side. Introducing a little chaos into the cartel supply line is one of them. If you do, they'll assume your arrival on the train is just an unscheduled delivery. And if nothing else, the looks on their faces will be highly amusing.
operation? If so, we can hit the factory without them suspecting a thing. Just disable the vehicles, find the key card, and wipe the CCTV when you're done. On the other hand, you can go in guns blazing. You'll be blowing your cover for the final raid, but if that's how you want to do it, go ahead. Even in that getup, they'll still lose their cool if you're spotted wandering into the more sensitive parts of the building. Thank you. inside. Yeah, that's right. We're gonna Trojan horse this factory. Look for something we can use. Seize it and bring it back.
Done out there. When your train arrives at the factory, the cartel will assume it's a delivery instead of a full-scale seizure of their assets. Hey, it's my pleasure to inform you that we have officially completed all necessary preparations to move forward with the Cluckin Bell operation at your earliest convenience. Let's make this happen.
It's clear this place is barely functioning as a chicken factory. One would assume they'd have more Cluckin Bell staff to keep up appearances, but I underestimated just how bold criminals can be once they have the police in their pocket.
Thank you.
next target. You know what to do.
I should have done it. Have you received the safe code? The safe's code should show up on the hacking device. That's it. All set. Okay, I'm listening to the radio, and it sounds like that safe triggered some alarm. They're shutting down most of the roads leading away from the factory. Fortunately, we're one step ahead of them. The getaway car should be right where you left it.
We got no way to go now.
situation has livened up my day-to-day considerably. Makes a pleasant change from people holding up to me.
Excellent work. Mission accomplished. Now to the vital matter of payment. As I'm sure you can appreciate, there are certain transactions I can't be party to as an officer of the law. If I've learned anything from my consultants on the LSPD, it's how to look the other way. Now remember, as far as I'm concerned, you can hit that factory as often as you'd like. As long as you're giving me reasons to keep looking the other way, I'm happy. As you can see from my choice of transportation, my fortunes at the LSPD are also improving. Just got these babies in, fresh off the line. Guess who picked one up? Until next time, let's disassociate.
To confirm that your compensation is in your account. And of course, to congratulate you again on a successful operation. Our efforts to derail the Cluckin Bell cartel's efforts were indeed effective, but it won't be long before they and their corrupt counterparts in the LSPD rebuild their little enterprise. Each and every time we knock them back down, I'll ensure it's worth your while. Effenberger out.